Let's see, beginnings. I guess beginning tonight really began with me, with Janice telling me about tonight. And then Tim sent me an email and said, won't I please show up? And when I heard about the subject, beginnings, I tell you, that really hooked me. Because I love beginnings. Especially the ones when you really don't know it's a beginning. When you get up in the morning and you meet somebody for the first time. A great relationship. I mean, we've heard about them here today. You know, a great journey. You know, it's just really kind of hits me. I really like beginnings, and the ones that you don't know about are the best. My favorite one is actually when I was about 12 years old, my grandmother gave me some newspaper clippings from the Civil War. And they were written by my grandfather. He was a correspondent. He fought in the Civil War. And that really got me hooked on journalism and history and writing. And I've been writing ever since. It started when I was in school. And like I said, you go there and you never know when you're going to get a great friend like Bill Handy, who's in the audience. He's my prop today. So, and you know, I look around, I know a lot of people here, and you know, that it's all started on some kind of chance encounter. And it just really makes that day great. Journalism, I've been writing, since I was about 17 years old, and being paid for it, which is even better. And today it's very special because a lot of people don't get paid for writing. I quickly became a courthouse reporter. And I actually later wrote a book and some newspaper stories where I mentioned this place, the Stottsville Inn. And they were integral as a location, if you don't know, of the Johnston murder cases. I wrote a book, and actually, yes, and actually I was locked up with the Bruce Johnston Sr. one night for 2 hours, and this was a location where one of the bodies was dug up just in back of here, and actually I gave a talk here on the book a few years ago. When I was in the newspapers, I said, you know, I never knew what was going to happen every day. Every day was a new beginning. You know, and when I went around and talked with schools, I said, you know, some days I get up and I might cover a story at the White House, which I did, or I might end up at night in a jail cell with a mass murderer, which I did. So each day, those new beginnings, I love beginnings every day, and I think it kind of all makes us just, you know, kind of alive if you look up and you're ready to meet the challenge of the new day and look for those beginnings in a positive sign. After I finished my career at the local, I started my own business, which was another beginning, but I did it a lot so I could write my own books and kind of be my own boss. And each book has a journey, which starts, of course, with the beginning to the end. The Johnston book, you know, I kind of knew that I really wanted to do it. But there were other books that I had no clue that I was going to write them until I had that beginning and I met somebody. That kind of sparked it. And when I do a book, it'll take sometimes 4, 5, 6 years. So I really got to love the subject. As you can tell, I love people. People's story, which really what brings me in. And that's what I think really history, and this is what it's all about. It's just kind of people. One of my favorites was, when I started off, was I was a sports writer. And one of my later books was on Richie Ashburn of the Philadelphia Phillies. And it was just by chance. I didn't want to get, you know, I didn't set out to do a book, but I was down at the Phillies game and just had a chance seats that I'd won in some kind of lottery. And I later learned that the ushers are switched every 10 games from different sections. And so I was randomly there with this random usher who loved what he was doing. It was a beginning for him. He was a new usher and was like his favorite and most sought after retirement job, watching baseball. And here was a guy who just loved to talk. And he was very enthusiastic. And at the end, I didn't get a word in, but at the end he said, "What do you do?" I said, "I write books." He said, "I have a book for you." Now, most people say that and don't have a book, but he had a book. He had actually met Richie Ashburn, he was 7, reintroduced himself later, and before the internet, he solicited almost 200,000 signatures and dumped them on Cooperstown saying, Richie ought to be in the Hall of Fame. And his campaign was, why the hall not? I didn't say hall. Even though people introduce me when I do that, they mess up the hall with something else. But it's why the hall not. But that was the beginning of the book. One of the other ones, you know, again, just not thinking about doing. Like I said, my relative was in the Civil War, and his brother fought at Gettysburg, and I was up there one day. And there's millions of books, it seems like, written on Gettysburg. Matter of fact, when I was doing some research, somebody said in 1880, there were at that point, too many books on Gettysburg. And I was just looking across the field at the high water mark, and I had an idea for a different book on Gettysburg, and just kind of hit me as I was standing there. Again, it was the beginning of a journey that lasted 4 or 5 years, but it ended with my latest book. So I love beginnings. Thank you so much for picking the topic. I heard the bell, and thank you.